6 for Sand City, as well as around the Monterey Peninsula to Carmel. So a cool start, but this clear sky is going to allow nice viewing for our partial solar eclipse. Now keep in mind, the total eclipse where it actually gets dark and you can look towards the sun, that doesn't happen locally. So if you are going to enjoy this and want to look at the sun, make sure you pick up one of these really cool looking pair of sunglasses that will protect you from looking at the sun. Now we are going to have a clear sky, which is great for viewing opportunity. Now the eclipse begins a little after 10 o'clock, let's say around 10:15, give or take. It's different from areas like Hollister to Santa Cruz to Salinas, but most of the region will see that maximum partial eclipse around 11:15 this morning, 11:17 around Salinas, and then that comes to an end a little after noon. Also a cool trick, if you don't have glasses, if you look down at the ground between the leaves, those cast a shadow that looks like the eclipse. So it'll be a view of the shape of an eclipse. Now, so what that is that cuts off part of the sunshine. So the moon is nestled between the earth and the sun around the peak of that. So a little after 11 o'clock, and that'll cast a shadow on earth. So where you see that full shadow, that is where that path of totality is. That's where this is a huge deal. Locally, unfortunately, we're not going to have that big of an impact. The total path runs from Texas through parts of the Midwest and the Ohio Valley and then up to the Northeast. That's where it'll become dark for about 4 minutes or so. For us, not going to become dark. Again, not safe to look at that sun. We're going to be around 37% covered. The sun will be covered 30% by the moon. So still a cool sight. Grateful that we have nice clear weather. When this happened before, we saw a partial eclipse in August of last year and again in 2017. And we had some clouds around. 2017 particularly, we had to go inland. So it'll be nice today that no one has to travel to see that partial eclipse. And then temperatures today in the upper 60s to 70s, 40s for tonight. And then over the next few days, gradually warming up. Lots of 70s, maybe even some 80s by Wednesday or Thursday. And then we do have those slight chances of showers moving through Friday through the weekend. Maybe another chilly system. So the roller coaster ride of temperatures continues for the next week or so. Jacqueline?